Hello everyone, this is Crota giving you a shoutcast in a game between Sky and Lin. Here on Turtle Rock, two of the more famous Warcraft 3 players out there, Sky and Lin. Sorry for bumping the microphone, I don't have my shock mount yet as that all costs money. Anyways, we have Lin spawning as the blue orc player here at the 4 or 5 o'clock position of Turtle Rock. Meanwhile, Sky spawning as the red human player over here at the 9 or 10 o'clock position of Turtle Rock. And I'm very, very curious as to how Sky is going to play. Sky at one point was one of the more feared human players. That was, of course, prior to the tower nerf that all human players received. Masonry upgrade no longer protects and adds nearly as many hit points or armor. So we'll see if tower attempts are still part of Sky's repertoire or if he has learned a few new tricks. Opening builds most likely will have an Archmage versus a Blademaster. If it's not an Archmage, I do believe it will end up being a Mountain King. I can't imagine any other hero as we now see Sky going for that Archmage there. Now the key question is going to be how will these players scout each other out? You can see the Peon now making his round. He is going to see that it is not going to be a close spawn here on Turtle Rock, which is actually going to be good news for Lin. Early game, human players are able to call to arms, get a lot of militia, and then press and deal a lot of damage early on with the help of those towers. That is not going to be the case this time around, as the walking distance is going to be a little bit further. We'll see whether or not we're going to have another building placed down here, most likely a farm. And that actually looks a little bit too large to be a farm location. Perhaps two farms can fit right here. And there is no building grid to help me out. As we now see this one footman make his way across the field to see if it is going to be a cross spawn. As now the Archmage with some militia and a footman going to try to take down these giant sea turtles. Blademaster, on the other hand, going to be going straight into either this shop over here. Where is it? The shop over here, perhaps windwalking around in order to try to get some damage onto the Ogre Magi without actually taking any damage from these Ogre Warriors. You can see there that the Ogre Warriors are unable to get within melee range as the Ogre Magi will get taken down. And the Blademaster going to get that Circlet of Nobility from the shop and also pick up the Rune of the Watcher, a very nice item. And also perhaps a Claws of Attack +9, I think, is the item there. As there's the Rune of the Watcher. And what item was dropped? Pendant of Energy. So a lot of energy now sitting on that Blademaster as that Blademaster runs back home to heal back up. Meanwhile, we see Sky now putting in a little bit of early pressure with the Water Elementals and Footmen trying to push back the Grunts. The Grunts are just going to be able to hide in the backfield. Voodoo Lounge taking a little bit of damage, but not very much. It is on fire. But for some weird reason, orc buildings just don't burn down. Now we'll see what's going to be happening here as a Peon going to get taken down. Oh, yes, it does get a long-distance fireball shot from the Archmage as the Blademaster now coming in. The Blademaster does have a lot of healing going on. He has two healing salves, and now perhaps it is going to be a healing disruption. And oh, no, it is not going to be a healing disruption as a Windwalk strike breaks Windwalk, and the Blademaster gains a little bit more experience. Footman now backing off here. Archmage looks like he is going to perhaps buy a Dust of Appearance and also that Boots of Speed. And I forgot to give my customary introduction to Warcraft 3 Wednesday. I hope you guys do enjoy it. As Gauntlets of Ogre Strength +3 have now been laid down. We can see Dust of Appearance being used by the Archmage, wanting to make sure that no Windwalk Blademaster was nearby. And now, with a Mantle of Intelligence and some Brilliance Aura, he does have a little bit more mana, and that mana may be able to help him out, summon more Water Elementals, and also giving him +3 damage. Intelligence on an Archmage, very, very potent, dealing extra damage, increasing the mana recovery, and also increasing maximum mana for even more Water Elementals. Back over here, you can see the Grunts now going after the Arcane Vault. Arcane Vault taking a bit of damage already, and the Grunts are just being able to hit there, and too bad they do not have Pillage at this time, as the Blademaster, once again, I believe, gets another Rune of the Watcher. Yes, another Rune of the Watcher by Chek Pu, who is, in fact, Lin in this matchup, and now the Arcane Vault just taking a lot of damage. We are now sitting at keep. It looks like we should be picking up, I believe, a Beastmaster in just a moment. And as soon as a Beastmaster comes out, we are going to see a little bit of pressure being placed down by Quill Beast and Water Elementals trying to focus down these units here. You can see the peons are desperately trying to repair it. This one footman taking a lot of spear damage so far, now trying to back off a little bit further and now going to re-engage instead as now the Beastmaster comes in with some Quill Beasts, and now the peons being forced to pull back here. One very low hit point footman down to 28 hit points. It does get taken down by Lin, as Lin now going after some of those grunts back over here. There is a war mill, but no tier 2 buildings yet coming in from Lin. It looks like this grunt is going to have a very, very bad day. Yes, it does get taken down there, as now the Beastmaster trying to take down the Voodoo Lounge with the Blademaster sitting at level 2 may be able to disrupt this, as now in comes some Windwalk Strike as Quill Beast now go after some very vulnerable grunts. Grunts taking down to half damage already as the grunt now trying to back off. Blademaster going after that footman there. As battles are going all across the map, this footman most likely will get taken down. Meanwhile, the Beastmaster chasing after this grunt, and the grunt down to 39 hit points and going to die to the the axe of the Beastmaster there. The Blademaster finally getting his man as that backs off. You can now see Bestiary was canceled quickly by Lin. Meanwhile, we are going into a Shadow Hunter. The Shadow Hunter will be out in just a moment, as that Shadow Hunter will be able to cast Hex. That's going to be a bit of a problem, as the Grunts now taking a little bit more damage than they want to. You can see Lin backing off with that Grunt down to 195 hit points, and now out comes this Shadow Hunter. Shadow Hunter should be able to take down these Quill Beasts rather easily. Down goes one Quill Beast. I'm not quite sure how that Water Elemental was taken down, either by timer or by hit points, as this Quill Beast just running around on the inside of the base could get some damage onto the Bestiary in order to make it get canceled perhaps. As now, oh, will the Quill Beast be able to get this disrupting attack? And no, unable to get the disrupting attack onto the grunt, and that grunt will naturally heal back up. We can see ivory towers have been picked up. We are do we have the masonry upgrades? I can't tell. No, we do not have the masonry upgrades at this time, as the Blademaster going after the Ogre Warrior. Blademaster will most likely get to level 3 and then leave the party, as the Shadow Hunter wants to be able to creep by himself. Now Blademaster, oh, a little bit shy, 30 experience away, as the Shadow Hunter now making his way off over here. Gonna go after these giant sea turtles, but now in comes some militia from behind as well, as the towers are now coming into play. Blademaster already straight on this slow now being casted. No slow being cast just quite yet. It looks like one tower will get destroyed. Down it goes. Another tower is gonna get destroyed very easily, as it is just getting focused down. And another tower over here, as now we see the Speed Squirrel being used. And now, Sky not able to really fend or really press with this attack. But the giant sea turtles joining in on the fight, causing a bit of damage to the Shadow Hunter, as now the Quill Beast and now getting some damage from that giant sea turtle as well. A grunt does get taken down, slow being cast. Blademaster now wind walks away, able to catch back up perhaps to that priest, as now one guard tower is already being upgraded and a second scout tower now being built. You can see the Beastmaster going after these sea turtle hatchlings. They will get taken down pretty easily, as the Shadow Hunter is going to get rehealed back in the middle of the field and perhaps try to come back in. Five peasants in this group, and now we are going to go to ensnare. The Kodo Beast does have a footman in its belly, as the Blademaster quickly coming in trying to take down a sorceress. The sorceress is unable to really do anything at all while in that crab form, but the middle student now losing, or sorry, Sky now losing a lot of his towers. Down goes a grunt, but this one demolisher going to spell problems, as now all the guard tower can do is just try to sit there and be repaired. Another hex quickly cast onto a sorceress. The sorceress will get taken down, but will the Shadow Hunter get taken down is the key question. There's a slow, there's the speed scroll, and the speed scroll may just be enough. Will the sorceress get another attack off? And now there's the healing salve, as the Archmage now goes hunting after this one the slower Shadow Hunter. The Shadow Hunter down to 90 hit points, 67. It will get taken down, as the Beastmaster looking to finish it off. You can see the Shadow Hunter down to 27 hit points. The Archmage, no boots of speed, not quite sure what's going on there, as the Shadow Hunter down to 6 hit points, getting a hex off, but finally getting destroyed there. You can see the priest and the Blademaster still continuing after all of these peasants. Level 3 Blademaster, almost level 4. As this game gets underway, Shadow Hunter is going to resurrect very, very quickly, as it was only level 1, and now we'll see what we have in store for Sky. Sky really needs to focus down this giant sea turtle, but in comes the Blade Master. Blade Master gonna get slowed here, but was not gonna really be able to go after these sorceresses. The Blade Master does have some mana, but not quite enough to really be able to get some kill steals. Now going after this one priest here, and now it looks as though this giant sea turtle may get taken down in just a moment. That is the key question. Can he steal the experience? There's the dust of appearance. Blade Master now hiding off over here. As you can see, this giant sea turtle down to 313. In come the militia. In come some spellbreakers as well. This Blade Master still hiding off over here. Gonna get some damage onto that one the Blade Master once again, making sure that it is unable to get any of that quick steals there. And now the giant sea turtle needs to get taken down. The Blade Master is now in play. And oh, the Blade Master may get the kill. No, does not get the kill. As we see, the Wand of Mana Stealing has been picked up. What, Spellbreaker now getting ensnared. It looks like it will get taken down. As you can see that the Spellbreaker is trying to fight back against Lin's Blade Master, not looking too good. Sorceresses and Spellbreakers still battling it out here. Archmage now sitting and now getting a Wand of Mana Stealing onto the Blade Master. Blade Master now low on mana, I believe, or was that on a different hero? Not quite sure there. As the Demolisher is now demolishing all of those casters. Down goes one Sorceress there, as now we have a level 4 Blade Master in this engagement. It looks as though the Raider will get taken down. Down it goes as Militia joining in on this fight. One of the Militia very low on hit points already. But now it looks as though Lin is going to lose his Kodo and end up giving back another Priest. So a Priest now back into play. Is the Slow going to be cast? Oh, a Raider does get destroyed here. No Slow to counteract. The Demolisher just rolling ever so quickly away. Something that you rarely don't ever see, as normally mortar teams and just siege units move very slowly. Now, a bear is in play, and a bear, very interesting that Sky actually went for a bear, something that you don't normally see, as you normally see a hawk. The hawk is generally better, as it does reveal any windwalked or invisible units, as we now see Lin attempting to clear out, but the Blade Master is very low on hit points. Is it going to be able to windwalk away? Down to 75 hit points. 54 does have a potion of greater healing. It needs to get away, and in a hurry, as the Blade Master now is using up a healing salve, is spirit linked, and it looks like it will be able to recharge. But this is going to buy precious time for Sky to continue his creep advantage. Level 3 right now compared to, I believe, a level 4 level 3. A Blade Master is level 4. Where is that Shadow Hunter? Shadow Hunter is level 2. So 4-2 versus 3-3. Blade Master is in this group. Is a Dust of Appearance going to be used? No, it is not. And there's the Windwalk Strike stealing the item. Ring of Protection, I believe. No, it is not a Ring of Protection. Boots of Speed, perhaps? Or a Potion of Greater Healing. Not quite sure who was able to take the item. No, the Beastmaster was able to take it. It was still a Wand of Mana Stealing. As we now see creeping going on down over here, we can see Sky attempting to get to level 4, and level 2 Brilliant Aura would be an absolute huge advantage for this caster-centric army. Very important, as you can see the Troll Trapper takes the item and the tome, and now able to run away once more there. You can see that the one Blade Master is currently slowed, but able to windwalk away again, as we now see a Quill Beast going after this Orc Burrow. Priests now coming in. The Priests are not upgraded at all. Sorceresses do have invisibility, and we are not going into Tier 3, so we are not going to have any of the human tri-hero, as we sometimes or often see. Beastmaster now going to engage. One poor sorceress is ensnared and going to get destroyed. Healing Wave cast. Disenchant. This is looking very, very bad for Sky. Sky is unable to really get any of those summons down, so without the additional summons, the Archmage and the Beastmaster really not that strong. Now another Speed Scroll being used, as the Spellbreakers taking some of that Spirit Link and casting it across their group once more. Beastmaster is using a Potion of Invulnerability, going after units, and level 4 now on the Archmage, as the Archmage gonna battle it out, and it looks like Sky is gonna be able to come out slightly ahead, but Beastmaster is ensnared, does use a Potion or Scroll of Healing to stay alive, and there's the Invisibility, and how is he revealed? There's a Dust of Appearance, and the Dust of Appearance on the Beastmaster Wow, brilliantly played by Lin, as Lin uses the Dust of Appearance to break invisibility. Perhaps knowing that that could have come in the future. You can see now a slow being once again recast. And now this Spirit Walker is going to be in trouble. Very, very low on hit points and also slowed, as the Spellbreaker is going after one unit there. And now what is going to happen? We already have a Sorceress hanging around by the tavern, going to most likely instantaneously resurrect that Beastmaster. Beastmaster now back in play, as we'll see what is going to happen here. Brilliance Aura now on that Beastmaster. So Quill Beast will be joining in on the fight very, very soon. We can see now a couple Spirit Walkers taking a lot of piercing damage and also taking some feedback damage. This is not good, as a healing wave had to be used in order to save these units here. And those units are just padding on top of each other. This is not looking good at all. Blade Master now coming in. The Beastmaster is still relatively low on hit points. There's the invisibility. And not going to fall to Dust of Appearance again, as now the Shadow Hunter losing a lot of mana from the Spellbreaker's attacks. Beastmaster now once again rejoining in on this fight, gonna get ensnared. Beastmaster is in a bit of trouble. Scroll of Healing could be used. There it goes. Now Beastmaster once again being invisible, does have the Scroll of Town portal, so it can escape if need be. Sorceress is still battling it out, and this fight is just going on and on and on. Spellbreaker able to finish off that Spirit Walker, as the Spirit Walker's getting just feedbacked by those Spellbreakers. Spellbreaker's not even upgraded, but that feedback damage starting to add up. Both sides getting higher and higher level, and this game is still too close to call, as the Archmage now halfway to level 5, but the Blade Master almost level 5 himself, but doesn't have that much mana, so he's not going to be able to windwalk all too much. Down goes a priest, in comes a bear, so an even bigger bear coming in, almost essentially a knight at this point. 900 hit points, dealing 28 to 30 damage. The Spirit Walkers could try to disenchant, but not very cost effective, as the bear dealing so much damage to those raiders. Raiders are getting destroyed, but now level 5 on the Blade Master. Very long fight. Spellbreaker trying to run away. Will it be able to? Getting even more feedback damage onto the Beastmaster, or the Blade Master, as now the Spellbreaker getting in some easy shots. It looks like it will get taken down by a grunt before the grunt gets taken down as well. Oh, the bear even has bash to add insult to injury. Beastmaster backing off again. One priest just trying to heal up this unit there, as the Blade Master is in a bit of trouble, and I think the standing army of Sky is just so much larger that there's not much that can be done. So much healing, so many summons, and no disenchant in order to stop it. Disenchant taking a lot of energy, as now Beastmaster most likely will get invisibled once again. In come the Blade Master. The priest just gonna heal that Beastmaster as it is invisible, and the Blade Master may get taken down. It does have a potion of invulnerability. It should use it soon. And nope, I believe that was the GG, and Sky taking game one in this series. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed game one in this series.